Good evening and a very warm welcome. I'm Alan Thomas and I'm proud to be here this evening on behalf of Hiscox, introducing our annual debate in partnership with the Royal Institution. So as an insurer, we help people take risk, and which is what the RI has been doing for over 300 years. And this year's topic is business success, what's luck got to do with it?
Larry King once said, those who've succeeded at anything and don't mention luck are kidding themselves. Well, somebody's already mentioned the luck of the Irish tonight, and being Irish, I am a lucky person. I absolutely believe in luck. I was brought up in the concept of luck. We're lucky people. We, even in the current economic climate, where there are 600,000 unfinished properties in Ireland, which will probably never be finished, our glass is always half full, especially just before we finish it and somebody takes it to replenish it at the bar. I think it's a bit of both. I think if you don't work hard at spotting the opportunities, then you won't be lucky enough to travel down a road that will lead to success.
The CEO of Google was asked at a conference about what the number one factor influencing his success was. He said it was luck, and I think that stunned the audience because they didn't expect him to be so candid. I think that sometimes there's a stigma about admitting that luck's really important in success because it should be all about hard work and nothing should be left to chance. But actually, luck is something that can be really important in propelling us forwards.
I think that although luck is something that cannot be influenced, this blind luck, serendipity is a type of luck that can. And we can prepare our minds to help us be more adept to having those aha moments. And we can also take actions to turn unexpected circumstances into valuable outcomes. And that means that in a way, I think that luck and hard work go hand in hand.
I don't think it's a perfect formula for business success, but I think luck does play a role. People often talk about being in the right place at the right time, but I think there are things you can do to increase the chances of being in the right place at the right time.
Broadening it out, you might generally think yourself to be a lucky person because you're comparing yourself to other people who maybe don't have the things that you have, don't have the job that you're happy with and the nice family. You might not feel as though you've acquired those things by luck or by chance, but you consider yourself lucky by comparison. And it also relates to an area of psychology known as resilience, the way in which people deal with adversity. And one thing that people draw upon in those situations is comparing what actually did happen, or what is happening, to what might have happened. Or the fact that, well, things are happening pretty good, it could be much worse.
I define it in two ways. Firstly, I believe strongly that there is such a thing as pure chance. Winning the lottery is an obvious example. Chance encounters, falling in love, these kinds of things can be down to luck. But I believe that there are certain kinds of people who are primed, if you like, to spot those kind of opportunities. I think luck is very much linked to opportunity.
I think there are an awful lot of people who are horrified by surprises in themselves, what people reveal to themselves about themselves as they get older. And I think it's those people who really struggle to break out of a worldview and a view they have of themselves after the age of 18 or 20. I believe it really gets cemented at that age. But if you can break out of that and say to myself, I should not be a prisoner of perhaps a negative self-perception, I'm potentially capable of far more than I think I am, you will achieve more.
The first one was, you know, timing. There was a real opportunity for us to sort of move into the market and put ourselves in that sort of middle sector within the brands that we sell for online fashion. A great friend of ours who worked for a big investment bank was really crucial in some of those key introductions to help us raise investment. So, you know, again, it was opportunity, and then it's what you do with that. And that's how I really believe, you know, the term luck is made.
If you just rely on luck to build your business, I think you're possibly slightly naive. And maybe a little bit lazy. If you just focus on hard work, it's like the sort of example, you're going to miss the opportunity because you're going to be so focused and so looking down that you won't see these opportunities that arise. So I truly believe it's a balance.
Working for an insurance company, I spend my working life taking decisions about chance and outcomes. So clearly luck plays a big part in my day-to-day. Or is it about judgment? So for me, you can manage luck in some ways, and really, it's always in the background, but outcomes are more affected by what you do than just pure chance, is my experience.
And thank you very much for being such a participative and interactive audience.